Local authorities have emphasized to the crew members the importance of adherence to the established COVID-19 safety protocols. Any breach of protocols will see violators facing fines or confinement wherever applicable.
At the marina, we, the Ministry of Health, have protocols, put protocols in place so that we could safeguard the general public, especially in the, when we have a lot of foreigners coming in. And you know, this ARC event is an annual event, so we have all the necessary protocols and guidelines, strict protocols and guidelines, so that the people coming in can adhere to, right? With the ARC event, persons we get all the information prior to the persons arriving, so we have all the information, the travel history, right? All persons are required to do a PCR test before the race begins, right? And they have to undergo a quarantine period over in Las Palmas. Upon entry to St. Lucia, right? Persons are screened by the Port Health team, right? The nurses will do the necessary checks, right? And ensure that persons are COVID-free, basically, right? Persons, again, would have a next assessment would be done, right? In terms of a next PCR test would be done. Persons would be placed on quarantine. At the marina, we have designated special areas for persons undergoing quarantine, right? Again, those persons would be tagged with the necessary bands so that persons in the general public could identify that those persons are on quarantine or those persons are within the bubble or within low-risk countries.
All information is gathered prior to the participants' arrival, and considering that all will not arrive at the same time, Shaman says, the crew members will be screened and placed in quarantine in a timely manner as there are adequate resources in place. A total of 454 crew members are expected to participate in this year's event. In all the planning, according to the general manager of the IGY Marina, the health and safety of citizens, team members, and their families was the number one priority for stakeholders across the board.
For those vessels that will be in the racing class and will probably get here before the 14 days, we have designated a dock which we'll walk around to show you, which is J Dock. And that dock is the quarantine dock. So for example, for a vessel that is going to arrive in 12 days, the balance of their quarantine must be done at the dock, where they will not be allowed to get off the boat. They will not be allowed to walk down the dock or anything else. Provisions have been put in place by the sponsors and the tenants of the marina to make deliveries to the vessel, but again, those deliveries are done at a distance where the items are placed on the deck of the boat, and those on board and the delivery supplier are distanced more than 40 feet apart because it's the length of the boat. When on quarantine, those clients will be placed with a red band by the Port Health for the duration of their quarantine period. On this red band, you will see it'll have the vessel name and the date of expiration, and therefore, and I encourage everybody in protecting St. Lucia, if you do see somebody with a red band, you know, that means they've probably breached protocol. And I encourage you to make a report to the marina office, to SLTA, to events company. Protecting St. Lucia but carrying out the event successfully is our main priority. And once that quarantine is over for that vessel, will then be revisited by the Port Health to conduct the necessary requirements and checks and balances. And they will be replaced with a blue band that says on it IGY sailing the Caribbean bubble. These bands will then be placed on the cruisers, and this indicates to you and I that they have gone through the necessary protocols which St. Lucia has put in place. They have conducted the necessary tests and isolations and everything of that sort. And then it's for us to show them a good time, give them a warm welcome and welcome them to St. Lucia like we have done every other year.
The general manager of the IGY Marina says that locals will be allowed to come into the marina to participate in the events set for the ARC, but will be expected also to adhere to the strict protocols which are put in place, such as the wearing of masks, hand sanitizing and social distancing, to name a few. With the cancellation of jazz, carnival and other events, Mr. Devo says the ARC will be the biggest event St. Lucia will host for 2020. For the DBS News World, I am Alex Bousquet.